प्यारा झंडा उठा रहे हमारा, सदा शक्ति बरसाने वाला, प्रेम सुधा बरसाने वाला, सदा शक्ति बरसाने वाला, प्रेम सुधा बरसाने वाला, वीरों को हर्षाने वाला, मातृभूमि का तन मन सारा।
देशभक्तों के बलिदान से स्वतंत्र हुए हैं हम। कोई पूछे कौन हो तुम, गर्व से कहेंगे भारतीय हैं हम। देशभक्ति देश के प्रति प्रेम और सम्मान की भावना है, इसलिए देश के प्रति अपनी निस्वार्थ प्रेम और गर्व प्रकट करते हुए एक देशभक्ति गीत हमारे शिक्षक गणों द्वारा प्रस्तुत हो रहे हैं। तो सीधा हम सभी लोग सीना थाम कर
Felicitate our history makers, our students who have set some records. Coming together is beginning, staying together is progress, and working together is success. Every success story has many chapters behind it of hard work, dedication, and now I invite Saji sir to facilitate our students.
विजेता वे लोग हैं जिन्होंने अवसरों को छोड़ना अस्वीकार किया हो। उनकी जीत किस्मत तय नहीं करती बल्कि काबिलियत करती है। इस प्रेरणादायक कोशिश को बनाए रखने के लिए विद्यालय की तरफ से अनुमोदन की गतिविधियां हमेशा जारी रहती है। विजेताओं के पुरस्कार वितरण के लिए तैयार होते हैं।
Respected Principal Sir, parents, my dear colleagues, and lovable children. India is celebrating its 75th Independence Day today. On this occasion, CBSE is honoring its meritorious students who came in the category of 0.1% who was awarded with merit certificate in class 10 and class 12. I would like to call those students to this stage to receive the certificate from our principal sir. He got the merit certificate in the subject Hindi and Biology. Second, Krishnendu. She got in chemistry. Then L. Aisharya. She's got in accountancy. Next, from class 10, Varsha. She got in Sanskrit. Govind P. Nambudiri. He got in the Sanskrit. Then Lakshmi A.S. She got in Hindi. Happy Independence Day to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. Honorable guest of honor, respected teachers, beloved students. Happy Independence Day greeting to all. India's Independence Day reminds the country's citizens of all the sacrifices the freedom fighters have made so that the later generation could breathe in free air and also to secure the country's future. Indian history is marked with the famous events of retaliation and uprisings, definitely laced with non-violence, which eventually drove the British out and forced former Viceroy Dr. Mountbatten to free India on August 15, 1947. Since its independence, India has made stellar progress in every field, including education, military, space programs, to name a few. This year, our proud nation celebrates its 75th Independence Day. In 25 years to come, India will celebrate 100 years of independence. Based on where the nation stands today, it is very reasonable to assume that in 2047, it will be counted among developed countries. India's economy is set to become the third largest in the world behind US and China. Indians by and large are enterprising people and have fascination for technology. With dynamic leaderships from time to time, India should be able to realize its dreams for the future. The country has a free road to travel, to explore and experience its rich diversity. This country, despite recent pandemic situation, lockdowns, etc., but still it has been successful in staving off mass hunger, and it is able to feed itself, is arguably one of the greatest miracles of present times. While governments, both state and central, have displayed appreciable verve in cobbling together fairly robust response systems to test and isolate the infected and also to arrest COVID spread. Even the Indian economy is showing small but visible signs of recovery. However, there are obstacles in our path of progress, such as extremism, insurgency, spread of populism, widespread corruption, growing inequality among the masses, and dire environmental decay. This is where the relevance and importance of education come into place, as right education is the only tool to overcome such adversities and threats of any country. So on this glittering day, we, the stakeholders of KVS, which is the premium educational organization of our country, must be aware of this unique duty and responsibility of nation building as people in the field of education. It's our duty to impart quality education to the society. Quote, "What looked sudden was long prepared," unquote, by Nobel laureate V.S. Naipaul, who observed in his book A Million Mutinies to Come Now about India's progress during 1980s. If we have to reiterate these words in 2050 also, each and every one of us will have to contribute our bit in this direction. I wish and sincerely pray that we, the citizen of India, will value and protect our invaluable independence from all threats within and outside. Once again, happy Independence Day. Now, I'm really feeling proud, thrilled, excited to introduce and welcome today's guest of honor, Ms. Safna Nasruddin, IAS, Sub-Collector, Malappuram District. Because it is a very proud moment for Kendriya Vidyalaya SAP due to a very special reason. Madam Safna Nasruddin, IAS, is an alumnus of KV SAP. And after her selection to this most coveted post, she has cleared her civil service examination with a top rank in her first attempt itself. And during all these interviews after this selection, she was very generous and more than what I should say, in a very much heartwarming manner, Madam has openly, honestly expressed her, what we can say, indebtedness towards KV teachers and KV system of education itself is a gratification to us. And just like I mentioned that every country need youth, especially youth leaders with a real dedication, passion, involvement, efficiency, productivity, and with the real personality. And we are very happy and elated because Kendriya Vidyalaya SAP Perurkada has done our bit in shaping, at least it is our claim that we have contributed to our society and our nation a great personality like Ms. Safna Nasruddin IAS. So on behalf of Kendriya Vidyalaya SAP and on my personal behalf, I with all love and affection, I most cordially welcome Ms. Safna Nasruddin, beg your pardon, as the guest of honor for this today's 75th Independence Day celebration of Kendriya Vidyalaya SAP Perurkada. Hearty welcome, ma'am.
Respected principal sir, my dear teachers and my dearest friends, a very warm good morning to one and all present here. It gives me immense happiness and pleasure to address all of you today, my school, on this auspicious occasion of our 75th Independence Day. As I address you people, I remember the days when I was a school kid in KVSAP, being there on our school ground, seeing our flag being hoisted, singing our national anthem, and I remember how enthusiastically we used to celebrate Independence Day. So what makes this day really special? What makes this day auspicious? What is the speciality of August 15th? Maybe somebody will say that because we got a transfer of power from British to Indian from August 15th, from this day, Indians, we started administering our country. But is that the only reason why August 15th is special? If you ask me, no. As our first Prime Minister, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, said, India's independence, our independence is a tryst with destiny. This day is auspicious because we laid the foundation for a transformation of this country on the day of 15th August. We wanted to improve everything in our country. We want to break away from the shackles of poverty, from illiteracy, from hunger, from unemployment. Or in very short, we wanted to take our country to greater levels, to greater heights. And we laid that foundation on the day of August 15th. And that is what makes this day really, really special and auspicious. One more thing I would like to tell you is all of us are history students, and we have read in our history textbooks about our freedom fighters, our freedom struggle. What is the speciality of our freedom struggle? The speciality of our freedom struggle lies in the fact that this is a mass movement. This is a mass movement led by leaders who had adhered to peaceful means, who had adhered to non-violence, who had adhered to satyagraha. Maybe this is the only mass movement where peaceful means was given prime importance. Our great forefathers, they had so many ideals in them, and they had stuck to all these ideals throughout the freedom struggle, and that makes our Independence Day all the more special. So one thing that I want to tell you, my dearest students, my dearest friends, is that have these ideals throughout your life. Have the ideal of discipline, of kindness, of humility, of hardworking, of being consistent, of being persistent throughout your life. These are the values. These are the values that got instilled in us, or these are the values that our forefathers aspired that we should have, all Indians should have. Along with this, one more thing that I would like to tell you is today, the world, not just our country, the entire world is fighting against COVID. So we need freedom from this virus as well. And how is that possible? It is only possible if we together, all of us together, adhere to COVID protocols and behave in a responsible manner, behave in such a proper manner that we observe masking, we observe wearing a mask, we observe physical distance, social distancing from each other, so that we can fight this virus. For that, we need the administration need all of your support. So all of you should be there, all of you should together fight against this COVID, and that is how we can fight over this virus. One more thing that I would like to tell you is, as Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam told, students are the future of this nation. They are the steering wheel of this country. So all of us are the future generation. All of you should always have these ideals in their mind. Be hardworking, be kind to everybody, be humane, and work for the success, work for our country, work for taking our country to greater heights. That is my message to all you out there. So once again, I'm wishing you all a very happy Independence Day. Along with that, I Principal Sir told me that today is your investiture ceremony as well. So I sincerely wish, and I'm sure that all of you taking oath today will have the ideals that our freedom leaders had in their mind, and will do your responsibility, will do whatever is entrusted upon you with all the sincerity. All the very best to everybody who is taking their oath today. Thank you so much.
Good morning to one and all present here, respected chief guest of the day, principal, vice principal, HM, all the teachers and my dear students, a warm welcome to the virtual investiture ceremony of the year 2021-22. As you all know, investiture ceremony is the most anticipated CCA activity of a school, where the students are prepared to don the mantle of leadership and discharge the responsibilities entrusted upon them by the school. It is celebrated in a befitting manner, where the student office bearers are honored with badges and sashes, along with receiving of flags. But in this current scenario of the COVID pandemic, we are forced to investiture ceremony virtually. But as all says, nothing is impossible. So we here, KV SAF family, takes the privilege to conduct the investiture ceremony for the year 2021-22. So on behalf of the entire SAP family, and as the CCA in charge of the school, I take the privilege to declare the student office bearers for the year 2021-22 with the blessings of God Almighty. So with the permission from Principal Sir, I am just reading out the secondary and primary school office bearers. The school captain, boy and girl, Pranav RM and Lakshmi AS from class 12B. School vice captains, Aman S and Gauri Srikant of 11A and 11C respectively. School sports captains, boy and girl, Abhinav B from class 12B and Alina S Jacob, class 12C. School CCA captains, boy and girl, Dhanush N and Charuta PR, both from 11A. And these students will be assisted by all the house captains and vice captains. Next, from the primary section, we have the school captains Advait S and Ritu Nandana FM from 5B. School deputy captains Anirudh Rajesh from 4C, Nandana R Nair 4A. School sports captains primary, Ayush A and Aknya Masai from 5C, and primary CCA captains Jonathan James from 5B and Gauri S. Nair from 5C. So I congratulate all the selected office bearers and wish you all success in this year, and I hope you will do your duties sincerely, and as a team you will all support the activities of the school and maintain proper decorum. Congratulations once again to all the office bearers. So next, since we have declared the office bearers, next we will have the prestigious oath taking ceremony. On behalf of all the student office bearers, I request Lakshmi Ayers, the school captain girl, to take the oath from the chief guest. And now I invite chief guest of the day. Excuse me, madam. Of all the student office bearers, I request Lakshmi Ayers, the school captain girl, to take the oath from the chief guest. And I humbly invite our chief guest of the day, Honorable Assistant Collector, Ms. Safna Nazruddin Ayers, to administer the oath to our students. Welcome, madam.
It is my ardent duty.
It is my ardent duty
to keep the banner of school high.
To keep the banner of
school high. My responsibilities include.
My responsibilities
include paying respect to my teachers.
Paying respect to my teachers.
Helping juniors.
Helping juniors.
Discriminating between right and wrong.
Discriminating between right and wrong.
Maintain decorum and cleanliness within the school campus.
Maintain decorum and cleanliness within
the school. I promise to abide by the rules and regulations of the school.
Abide by the rules and regulations
of which I am an integral part.
Of which I am an integral
part. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, madam. Madam is also, it is a privilege that we take the oath from madam, as she is also our alumna of KVSAP, and proud to have madam with us. Thank you so much. Thank you, Lakshmi. And now I take the opportunity to thank our respected principal sir to give this opportunity and conduct this program successfully. And I also thank Vice Principal Sir, HM Madam, and my fellow in charges, Rama Madam from the primary and Indu Madam, for supporting me and conducting this smoothly. And my heartfelt gratitude is there for all the dear housemasters who have supported throughout the program. Thank you so much, without which the program would not have been conducted smoothly. And I also thank Deepa PR Madam for assisting us in this online venture. And thank you so much to all teachers, students also. I thank you. Without you, the school is empty. So I once again thank you all children, because you are the main backbone of our school. So thank you so much all.
Respected principal sir, teachers, parents, and my dear students. On this auspicious occasion of the 75th Independence Day of our nation, I wish you all a very happy Independence Day, filled with a proud sense of nationalism and strongest feelings of patriotism. Independence Day, a day to commemorate with folded hands and thankful hearts the struggles, sufferings, and sacrifices of our ancestors to win us freedom from the harsh and exploitative rule of the Britishers. As we all know and understand, this battle for freedom was fought not with arms or ammunition, but by the unquenchable thirst of freedom, incomparable ideologies, unprecedented methods of protest, and uncompromising attitudes of our predecessors. It was the victory of people's willpower over the iron hands of their rulers. Innumerable hardships, strict rules and regulations, inhuman treatments, devastating weapons and deadly gallows, nothing could defeat the ardent desire of the people and their willpower. We should always remember with gratitude all those great souls who fought for the independence of our nation including our great father of the nation, Sri Mahatma Gandhiji. If our ancestors had taken countless troubles for winning independence for our nation, as the patriotic and responsible citizens of this great nation, it is our duty as well as obligation to lead our nation to greater heights and more reputable position among global nations in order to fulfill the vision and dreams our ancestors had about this nation, for which they had given so many sacrifices, including their lives. We should try our level best to do everything humanly possible by utilizing our ability, intelligence, talents, and creativity in the most appropriate manner in order to add to the glory and fame of this country. If many of those great souls who dedicated their lives for the cause of independence had opted to remain in their comfort zones, we would still have been eating the bitter fruits of foreign supremacy and slavery. The best way possible for us to express our sincere gratitude to those great souls is by participating in all the nation-building activities to the fullest of our potential. There are many Indians around the globe making our nation proud by their dedicated and appreciable efforts in various fields. Many Indians are in very reputed positions and in top administrative capacities in various organizations. Some affluent personalities of Indian origin have even been elected as head of other nations also. Our scientists and experts in the field of science and technology are enjoying an edge and reputation in their communities because of their tremendous caliber, hard work, and achievements. The scintillating performance by our youngsters in various sports and games, including the recently concluded Olympics, is surely making our nation count and all Indians proud. They are all noble and ideal examples and models for all of us to follow and succeed in our grateful desire. Independence is interdependence also, with mutual terms, without any superior or inferior, as equal partners, sharing our abilities, ideas, resources, efforts, etc., for mutual benefit. It gives us the freedom of thought, not bound by any restrictions or limitations of ideologies, regulations, and conventions. We should be able to fearlessly express our ideas and able to implement them for the benefit and betterment of ourselves and our society without hindering or damaging anyone else's freedom or right for peaceful existence. As we are entering into the 75th year of independence, so many activities are being planned and implemented for celebrating the occasion in the most befitting manner by the Government of India, state governments, and various departments and organizations under the label Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. Many of these activities are reflecting our Prime Minister Narendra Modi's vision of making an Atmanirbhar Bharat by the year 2022. I request all my dear students to participate in various activities and competitions conducted as part of these grand celebrations with a great sense of nationalism, patriotism, self-dependency, and a lot of enthusiasm. Once again, I wish you all a very happy Independence Day. Jai Hind.